Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this particular video, we will be discussing about basic concepts of GST, that is goods and services tax. What is GST? What are the benefits of GST? What are different components of GST? When GST was introduced in India? All these will be discussed here. As we know that GST has removed many laws, many acts in India. Before GST, we had many taxes like service tax, excise tax, VAT, custom, etc. But now we have only one tax, that is GST. However, some proportion of custom duty, excise duty are also applicable in some cases, but all these are exceptions only. But before going in detail, we need to know about different types of taxes. There are two types of taxes: direct tax and indirect tax. As far as direct taxes are concerned, these taxes are non-transferable tax. It is levied on the income and the activities conducted. That we need to remember, it is levied on the income and the activities conducted, and it is non-transferable tax. It means the burden of tax cannot be shifted in case of direct tax. Means it is paid directly by the person who has earned that income. It is paid by the person who has earned that income in that particular year. He cannot shift his tax burden on the other person. Like for example, income tax is the direct tax. Earlier we had wealth tax and gift tax. All these were also levied under direct tax, but now all these taxes have been removed. Indirect tax. As far as indirect taxes are concerned, it is transferable tax where the liability to pay tax can be shifted on the others. It means the liability to pay tax can be shifted from one person to the other person. It is levied on the product or services. That we need to remember, that it is levied on the product and services, or it can be levied on both. Indirect taxes, examples of indirect taxes are GST and some part of custom duty, excise duty are also applicable in some cases. Earlier we had service tax, excise tax, sales tax, central sales tax were levied, but now all these taxes have been removed and we have to pay GST. Along with GST, some part of custom duty are also applicable in case of import and export, but now all these taxes have been removed and we are paying GST. It means one nation for one nation, one tax we have. Actually, earlier we had very complicated, very complex tax policy. Means for different activities we had to pay different taxes, and these were levied by different government in India. But in order to simplify the complexity of all the taxes, government of India introduced GST. Means one nation, one tax. For one nation we have to pay one tax. Goods and services tax, it is applicable from 1st July 2017, and it is applicable on the supply of goods and or services or both. This word supply is very important here, supply of goods or services or both. In detail the supply word we will discuss in separate video, and we need to make difference between goods and services also. This tax is applicable to the whole of India. It means including the state of Jammu and Kashmir, this act is applicable, and this is applicable in order to simplify the tax policy. For one nation there should be one tax. So it is applicable on the supply. It is applicable on the supply of goods and supply of services or both. So what are the difference between goods and services? In simple words, we can say that goods means any kind of movable property. Any kind of movable property means the things that can move from one place to the other place, but it does not include money and securities. Securities like government security, bonds, shares, debentures, it does not include. However, it includes things attached to the farming part. It means things that are meant for sale, that the things that attach to the land and that are meant for sale can be goods, like actionable claim, like growing crops, grass, things, etc., that are attached to the land that are meant for sale can be goods. Services means anything other than goods. It means the things that is beyond goods. It does not include money and security, but it includes activities relating to the use of money. The activities that are relating to the use of money, like profession of a teacher, profession of a doctor, profession of an advocate, supply of electricity, water supply, services provided by restaurants, services provided by hospitals, all these are services. It means goods include the material cost, labor cost, other overhead cost, cost including profit. But services hardly include any material cost. It includes labor costs, it includes other overhead cost on which we have to pay GST. How GST is applicable, we can see it with the wonderful example here. Like manufacturers. Manufacturer means the person or the company manufacturing the goods. Manufacturers sell goods to distributors. Distributors sell goods to wholesalers. Wholesalers sell goods to retailers. Retailers sell goods to final customers, means who are the ultimate consumer of the goods. What customers pay to pay retailers in return of goods? Customer pay retailers the sale price. Sale price including cost price plus profit and plus tax to retailers. Retailers pay sale price means cost price plus profit plus tax on it to wholesalers. Wholesalers pay sale price plus profit sale price plus tax to distributors. Distributors pay sale price plus tax to manufacturers, and finally manufacturers pay tax to government. So who is the tax collector? Government is the tax collector. Who are the taxpayers? Customers are the taxpayers, but government cannot directly collect tax from customers. Government recover or collect tax from manufacturers. Manufacturers collect tax from distributors. Distributors collect from wholesalers. Then wholesalers from retailers. And finally, retailers collect tax from customers. So this is a form of indirect tax. In this form, we pay GST. Now, components of GST, what are different components of GST? Central goods and services tax, CGST, is the component of GST. State goods and services tax, SGST, and UTGST are the components of GST, and integrated goods and services tax are the part of or component of GST. In case of central goods and services tax, it is administered by central government. It means central government control the GST, control the tax. In case of SGST, it is administered by the state government. State government make rules for the tax, and state government control the tax. In case of UTGST, it means Union Territory Goods and Services Tax. In this case, it is to be administered by administrator appointed by the central government for the Union Territory. It means all the administrator who have been appointed by the central government for the Union Territory, they will control the tax. And in case of Integrated Goods and Services Tax, that is IGST. IGST is to be levied and collected by central government on the interstate supply of goods and services. It means in case of interstate supply of goods and services, the IGST is collected and levied by the central government. All these components will be discussed in separate video. Thank you so much.